In this video, we'll show you how to attach a Windows host to a PowerVault ME5 system that connects to the host using SAS protocol. Before you begin, complete the installation of your ME5 system hardware. Complete the basic setup of PowerVault Manager. Review the Dell PowerVault ME5 Series Storage System Deployment Guide for host cabling and setup instructions. Review the ME5 Series Storage System Administrator's Guide for information on configuring hosts and volumes in PowerVault Manager. And prepare a network planning worksheet based on the examples in the deployment guide. First, connect the ME5 system to your Windows host according to the instructions in the ME5 Series Deployment Guide. Your configuration may vary, but will look similar to this diagram. On the ME5 2U system, controller A is on the top and controller B is on the bottom. Ports on controller A are identified as port 0 through port 3 going from right to left. Ports on controller B are numbered in the opposite direction. Port 0 is on the left and port 3 is on the right. Now install MPIO on the Windows host. In Server Manager, launch the Add Roles and Features wizard. Click Next until you reach the Features page. And then select Multipath IO. Click Next. Select the box to restart the server. Click Yes, and then click Install. The server restarts to complete the MPIO installation. Use the PowerShell console to identify the SAS WWNs. Select Tools, then Windows PowerShell, to open the PowerShell console. Type get-initiator port and record the SAS WWNs on your network planning worksheet. Next, configure the host on the PowerVault ME5 system. Log in to PowerVault Manager. From the main dashboard, go to Provisioning and select Hosts. Select Create Host to launch the wizard. Enter the host name. Select the initiators for the host using your worksheet as a guide to map the SAS WWNs and initiator ID. You can give each host initiator a nickname. It is recommended to use something that clearly identifies the initiator for that particular host. Then, select Add Initiators to Host and click Continue. Optionally, attach the host or host group to a volume. You can choose to create a new volume during this step or attach the host to an existing volume. For this video, we will create a new volume to attach to the host. Select Attach Host or Host Groups to Volumes. And select Create New Volumes to Attach to Host or Host Group. Then click Continue. Select the pool in which you want to deploy the volume. Name the volume. Again, it is recommended that you include something descriptive of the volume use in the name, such as the host name. Click Add Volume. And then click Continue. Review the information for the host and associated volume and click Continue to complete the Create Host wizard. When hosts are created, you'll see a success message pop up. Next, use the Server Manager to discover the ME5. Open Server Manager, click Tools, and click MPIO. Click the Discover Multipaths tab. Select Dell EMC ME5 in the Device Hardware ID list and click Add. If Dell EMC ME5 is not listed in the Device Hardware ID list, ensure that the host has a minimum of one logical connection to both controllers. Lastly, discover and configure the volume in Windows. In the Server Manager, click on Tools and select Computer Management. Select Disk Management. Then right-click on Disk Management and select Rescan Disks. Locate your new disk in the list, right-click on the new disk and select Online. Right-click on the disk again and select Initialize Disk. Select the partition style for the disk and click OK. Right-click on the unallocated space and select New Simple Volume. Follow the wizard prompts to format the volume. Your ME5 storage system is now ready to be used by your Windows Server hosts. For more information or support about PowerVault ME5 hosts, visit Dell.com/support.